Hey guys, in this video we're going to be looking at how to scrape indeed.com using Python Scrapy. So we're quickly going to go first through the basics of how data is actually rendered on the page on the Indeed website. Then we're going to look at how to set up a proxy so we can bypass any antibots that are running on indeed.com. Then we're going to crawl for specific search terms like the job title and location. Then we're going to loop through all the different pages of data that get returned. And finally, we're going to parse the actual job data that gets returned for each job. So first off, we're going to git clone our basic Scrapy project. This is available for anyone to download, and we link it in the description of this video. So I'm going to go ahead and just git clone this. I have all the basic steps here to get the project quickly up and running in the cheat sheet section. So I have an empty folder right now in VS Code, and I have nothing in this folder, as you can see. So I'm just going to git clone that. Then I'm going to set up a Python virtual environment. So that's very quick and easy to set up. And then I'm going to install Scrapy, because that's the framework that we're using today. So we'll just give that a second to install. Okay, now that we have Scrapy installed, let's just check that it's working correctly. So let's cd into our basic Scrapy project and just run Scrapy list. So that gives us quotes, which is the spider, which is installed by default. So you can see our quote spider is here. So that's good. We've got the basic project set up. The next thing we want to do is install our proxy, which is going to enable us to bypass the Indeed antibots. So Indeed and many other large websites have antibots enabled on their sites to stop spiders from scraping their data. So there's also many other providers then who offer proxy services to enable spiders to bypass these antibots. So we're going to install one from ScrapeOps. You can go to the ScrapeOps website, go to the proxy page and sign up for a free trial account. And that gives you 1,000 free credits to play around with and use for this tutorial. So once you have your API key, the next thing you want to do is install the ScrapeOps proxy SDK, which basically integrates a middleware into your Scrapy project. And then that middleware will send all the requests to ScrapeOps. So let's just go ahead and pip install that. Perfect. And then once that's installed, we just go to our settings. We update our robots.txt obey to false. And if it's not already set to false, and we add in the ScrapeOps settings. So the proxy enabled true, the API key will be the API key that you get. I'm going to add in my own demo one now. And then this downloader middleware just to enable the ScrapeOps proxy middleware section. So obviously if you already have a separate downloader middlewares somewhere further down, you just need to add this line to it. Okay, so that's our proxy installed. Now the next thing we can do is we can look at how the data is displayed in Indeed on the website. So to do that, we're just going to open up Indeed. I've just added Python as the job search and Texas as where we're looking for. If you click find jobs, it runs away and gets you a bunch of jobs. So this is page 1 of 13,000 jobs. So the next thing we want to do is inspect the element by right-clicking on the page, going to inspect. If we open this up, we can see where the data comes in onto the page. So some sites have a front end and a back end, and the back end serves up the data through an API. Some other websites are completely server-side rendered, and then all the HTML and CSS is sent as a page to the browser to be displayed. And then Indeed, like some other sites, is a kind of a almost a hybrid where the page is mostly server-side rendered, but there is some data, like in this case, the job data, which is sent in a JavaScript object, and this is then in a script tag, which we can then access here. So in this hybrid format, all the data here is in this window.mosaic.initialdata JavaScript object. So if we go to console and just clear those, if you type in window.mosaic.providerData, you then can see all the data that is in this JavaScript object that's available to us. So we have obviously the job cards here, which obviously refers to these job cards. And if we open this up, we can see the metadata for it. Open that up further, we can see the results. And then here we have a bunch of different jobs with the company rating, the job title, etc., etc., etc. So this very first one here refers to this one that we can see on the page. So that's very handy. It makes it quite simple for us to scrape the data that we need. And we also have a summary, which is where we can get the total job count if we want to actually loop through and get every single job from this search result. So there are two very useful things to know. One, where we can get the total job count, and two, where the results are actually stored. So again, to do that, all you have to do is type window.mosaic.providerData. This may change, and in that case, you just need to go into your elements and find what the new name, if they ever rename it, of this JavaScript object is. Obviously, websites can change all the time, and every 6 months to a year, companies are launching new redesigns of their front and back ends. So keep that in mind as well. Now that we know where the data is on the page, let's start writing our spider and looking at how we can access this data. Okay, so let's go back to our spider. This is the default spider that we've downloaded. And now I'm going to create the spider to scrape Indeed. So I'm going to just delete what we currently have. And instead, I'm going to paste in a spider that is already written specifically for Indeed. This spider code I will link to in the description below too, so you guys will have the full completed spider ready to go, which you can download also. So to start off, obviously, this is just the class name Indeed Job Spider. The spider name itself is Indeed Jobs. And then what we have is a small function which just gets the URL with the properly encoded parameters when we run our search. So then we move on to the start requests function. Here we have the keyword list. We only have one keyword that we're going to be searching for, which is Python, and the location list, which is just going to be Texas. So obviously you guys can put in whatever you need to search for in the keyword list or in the location list, and you can have multiple of these keywords and locations. So as you can see, then we have two for loops. So first we're looping through the job titles themselves, and then we're looping through the locations that are in the location list. But because we only have one job title and one location, it's only going to actually execute once to do the initial search. So obviously this get Indeed search URL is what we talked about up here. It gets the full search URL properly formatted for us. We pass this into the Scrapy request function, which comes with the Scrapy framework, and that then once it requests the page, calls this callback function, which is parse search results. So if you're with me so far, I hope you are, we'll now look at the parse search results function, which, as the name suggests, parses the search results. So here we have it. So this parse search results takes the response that comes back from the Scrapy request function. We parse out the location keyword, and the main important part here is the script tag. So we're going to be using the regex library for regular expressions called RE in Python. This is just going to help us find the job cards where we have all the job related data. So using this function, we get everything to come back into this script tag, and then we load that into a variable called JSON blob using the JSON.loads function. So once we have everything in a JSON object, which is accessible to our spider, we can then go to the tier summaries part of the JSON blob and look for the exact amount of jobs that are available. So if you go back a couple of minutes, we looked at the total number of jobs that came back in the search result. So that's what we need, because obviously if we need to calculate the amount of pages that we need to loop through, we need to get the total amount of jobs and then divide that by a number that gets displayed on each page. So that's exactly what we're going to do here. We're checking, do we need to just search one page, or do we need to loop through multiple pages? So if we have multiple pages, we load the next page and do the same thing again, as you can see by this parse search results again, which gets, so every time if we go down and there's still another page to be loaded, we will load the search results on the next page too. Then to extract the jobs from the search page itself, we look at the JSON blob and we go all the way down to the results, which we also looked at on the Indeed website. And that's where we get the actual job listing themselves. So then in this job listing, our the list of jobs that we have, we loop through them using our for loop, and we get the full job URL, which is this base Indeed URL plus the job key at the end. And that enables us to get the single job page itself. And that's where we can extract all the job data that's relevant to us. So we have the full job URL, and then we can go ahead and again call the Scrapy request function on this full job URL, and we again have a callback function which kicks off once the response comes back. And I'll show you guys that parse function now. That parse job function takes in the response which comes back. Again, we want to use our RE module to search using regular expressions for the initial data, and this comes back into our script tag variable. We load it into again another JSON blob, and then we can in the JSON blob look for the job info model, which contains all the relevant job information, such as the company, the job key, job title, job description, and anything else. So obviously here we've just taken a small subset of the data, but there's a lot more data than that that you can access from the individual job page. Now obviously it depends, because you might not have to go into each individual job itself. You might have enough data from just the initial job search and the initial overview which is displayed. So you need to decide for yourself, do you have enough data in what is returned here, or do you need to actually go into the job itself and get, for example, maybe you need the full description. Maybe you're going to be parsing all this data and look for the qualifications. So in this case, you would need to go to the individual job page and get all the data associated with that job. But you also might just have enough with what is coming back in the search section. Okay, so now that we've run through the full spider, let's go ahead and try and run our spider. So to run our spider, all we need to do is type scrapy crawl and the spider name. Indeed jobs. Let's see, does that work? No module named scrape ops scrapy proxy SDK. That usually can just be solved by deactivating and reactivating the virtual environment. Deactivating it, go back up to where the environment is. Source venv bin activate. Okay. Then let's go back into our project and try run scrapy crawl again. And there's something happening. Okay, so we can see a lot of 429 errors coming back there. I'm just going to stop it quickly if it'll let me stop it. So we can see there is some job data coming back, but there is a lot of 429s coming back from proxy.scrapeops.io. So what we need to do to fix that is go into our settings and update the concurrent requests to 1. So that's because we're on the free trial for the proxy, and that just allows 1 request at a time to go through the proxy. So once we have that switched to 1, it should work correctly. So let's try run that again, and let's output this time using the dash O to results. I'll do JSON. So you can do CSV, whatever you want. I'm just going to do JSON because it is easier to read. So there you can see the results.json file is created. And here you can see there is job data showing up in the terminal. So if we go to our results, here we can see keyword Python, location Texas. You can see the page that was scraped, the position, the job key, job description. And as obviously we're only in the middle of it, a lot more jobs are going to come in here. So we can just leave that, continue running. And if you open it up every so often, you will see more and more jobs populating the list. So it's as simple as that, really, guys. There's not much to it. There's an accompanying article with all the code snippets and more in-depth detail. And I'll have a link to that article in the description below. Is there anything else? I don't think so. It's still working away. As you can see, the page number has changed, so it's now scraping a new page, which is exactly what we wanted it to do. Loop through all the different pages of the job data available and scrape the data. Okay, guys, thanks for watching the video. If there's any questions or comments you might have, leave them below and we'll get back to you on them. If you have any other ideas for videos you'd like us to do, or you get stuck on anything in particular, please let us know, and we'll do our best to help you out there too. Also, if you're enjoying the videos, please subscribe. Thanks, guys, and see you in the next video.